What a play last night in Edmonton. Ducks down by two, and Ryan Getzlaf with a shot. They score, but immediately Cam Talbot says, no, I was interfered with. Watch again. Corey Perry screens him, does make contact. This was reviewed, and after review, they said it was a good goal. That ended up leading to a Ducks comeback. They won the game in overtime, and here's an upset Cam Talbot after the game.
I thought that was pretty obvious. I don't know what else to say on that one. I mean, I try to play with integrity and not flop and dive, and I don't get the call. Maybe I need to start doing that to get the call, so I don't know what else to do on that one. He clearly hits my blocker and my pad, and no way I can make that save.
So let's take a look at the rule itself, okay? 69.3, it says contact inside the goal crease if an attacking player initiates contact with a goalkeeper, incidental or otherwise, while the goalie is in the goal crease and the goal is scored, the goal will be disallowed. Rule 69.4, contact outside the goal crease. If an attacking player initiates any contact with a goalkeeper other than incidental contact while the goalkeeper is outside his goal crease and the goal is scored, the goal will be disallowed.
Okay.
So I'm still confused about the rule. I think Cam Talbot still wants some explaining about the rule. That's what we're here for. In our own very own version of the rink, I get to be Cam Talbot. That
Solid.
Should be interesting.
Nice.
You guys, going to be Corey Perry?
Okay, so let's just look at those two, because it's an important distinction between those rules.
Right.
The first one, if you are in the crease, you, Cam Talbot, are in the crease, any contact, incidental or otherwise, results in no goal. So it doesn't have to be significant. Any
right.
kind. If you're inside,
we
crease,
you.
In the blue, on your knees, on your feet, whatever it is. If you're inside the blue, any kind of bump, a little brush of the hand,
this
whether
is
it's
my
a slap of the stick.
That's
your
that is your safe zone.
This
if we brush your puck goes in, no goal.
Right.
Very clearly. The tougher one becomes when you get out of the crease, it says if there is incidental contact or more than incidental contact, then it's no goal. So given the review we saw, we have to assume then that Cam Talbot was considered out of his crease because he's no question he was down on his knees like that. And his foot right here
right there,
was
yep.
kind of hanging outside the crease while his body was mostly inside the crease. Jamie,
this
exactly kind of like that. As Cam, and then as Corey Perry came in, he comes through.
Larson standing here.
He hits his foot on his feet. And you see how Cam Talbot's chest inside the crease. The foot outside the crease. So the foot is the point of contact primarily. That leaves us to believe that you are now considered outside the crease because your foot hanging out even if your body's in.
Mm-hmm.
That's number one. So now you're considered, and we can debate that.
Yeah,
we don't even know if that's...
But incidental was the
now,
word.
Now, the other thing we have to... Was it incidental or more than incidental? And that is the gray area of this rule. And that's what Cam Talbot doesn't like. That's what Corey Perry does like. He's made a career out of it. Now, you want to be...
I'm Adam Larson,
Adam Larson,
and I thought Adam Larson did a great job because Adam Larson, he doesn't want to come in front of Cam Talbot either and screen him. So he's standing here. He knows where the puck's going. So he stands here. But Corey Perry being Corey Perry knows exactly what to do. He sees enough room to squeeze
his
little body in it. He does the old 10-2 going by. Yeah. And as he goes by, he just touches that foot of Cam Talbot enough. Enough to throw prevent Cam Talbot off.
And also brush by his hands.
Right there.
And just enough to distract Cam Talbot.
That shot goes right in. And you see Talbot right after. He puts the hands up in the air, and he's not happy about it. So
I wouldn't be either.
So what did we learn? We learned that if you touch a piece of the goaltender who is outside the crease, even if the chest and the majority of his body is inside, the goalie is then considered outside the crease. If that's the area of the body that you made contact with, and if that's the case, then the standard of incidental contact is lower than within the crease. Now, we can have the conversation.
And we do.
Was that more than incidental? The click of the feet, the brushing of the hands, is that too much? They determined it wasn't. One thing I do think goaltenders will learn, and Cam Talbot said it, one way to get a call or to draw attention to the contact is to react. You see Carey Price, one of the best goalies in the world, he likes to initiate with guys around his crease and then let the referees know by his body motion that I have been bothered. sometimes you try to fight through it too well, you don't get that call. Cam Talbot tried to play it out, didn't get that call. Maybe he blows
it. He didn't react until after.
Until after it went through. If he reacts on the first contact and tips over.
He sees it coming. He moves into that Corey Perry there. That's no goal for sure. Yeah. And that's, we talked about Carey Price is extremely good at that. And then the other part of it is, you know what, Corey Perry, that's what he's made a living on that. And we're talking here, trust me, if Weeksy was here, he'd have a whole different story. Johnny and I are both forwards here, so we have no sympathy for the goaltenders. We have to have a little space to create some offense there and just enough to throw off a goalie was why it went in.
You know, we were just talking earlier in the show about embellishment and the idea of how that's not good for the game. So that begs the question, should there be more of that from the goalie's perspective, or should more people be like Cam Talbot and just rely on replay to decide it for him?
Ideally, you'd like to go Cam Talbot's route, where you'd say, you know what, play it out right, play it honest, play it through, and don't show it being more than it was. He tries to hang in there and make the save. After it goes by him, he gets his hands up in the air. So you don't want to encourage guys to make more of contact than there is. But it's human nature. Sometimes you don't feel you're going to get the call. If you're not going to trust the replay, then you want to blow it dead before it gets there. And maybe then they do that. You see that it's just a little tiny hit on the heel of Corey Perry as he tries to slide by. And it's enough to throw Cam Talbot. And also, goaltenders don't like... Big part of playing goal is, of course, all their balance. And when you start affecting their hands, not only is it can they not make the saves, but it affects their balance and how they move around because their stick is often a lever for their – so if you – even just little touches on the hands, just little brushes, it throws off their center of gravity, their movement. So that also is impacting. Corey Perry does it very well, just enough, but not too much. It's a tough call to make, but – interesting, the in and out of the crease part, because that was very much part of the discussion.
Exactly. And the other night, Chris Kunitz had a goal called back.
Yes.
And it's like, I thought it was going to be a good goal because I thought he was playing the puck going to the net, as we see here. Here's Chris Kunitz coming in. He's playing that puck. He does. Does he bump Braden Holtby? He does. But I thought because he was going to the net, his motion goes in. They reviewed it right away. What they were reviewing was whether or not the puck went in before the net came off, which it did. And then they challenged it. And now they're saying, oh, no. And as we see, the one thing we talked about it, he is fully in his crease. And as soon as he hits him in the crease, then it's no goal. And that they made the correct call. But that's where the confusion lies. And we thought 90% of Cam Talbot's body was in the crease, except for the big toe. Yeah. And the big toe was enough to throw him off his balance.
Goalies just want the right to stand there and allow themselves to try to make the save without being bothered. Their rights are more strictly enforced in the blue paint. A little tougher standard outside.
Maybe he just needs to get some skates like this.
There he would do well to, he would do well to wear those.
Real quick, a big shout out to the Oilers and Cam Talbot, because what an honor. I get to hold his stick. This is Cam Talbot. I know. I'm feeling a little more empowered already. No interfering with this goalie. Get out of my house.
Oh,
we'll be right back, Mark.